Okay, I think a lot of you still don't understand what you are supposed to do in this homework. I will try to explain it carefully, although the language of this homework is easy, but apparently when you read, you don't read every word I write. I will go over it very slowly and tell you exactly what you need to do. Submit links. What does that mean? You submit links. It doesn't say submit Word file. It does not say submit PDF file link, which means when you search on the internet and you find a good page, it has a link on top, which is the address. That's a link. So you copy that. That's the only thing you need, link, so that when we press that link, we go to that page, which you should obtain from searches on the internet on the following subject. So you have three subjects. We already have gone over those earlier, but I want you to learn more. You know, one of the most important purposes of these homeworks is for you to learn, not just to send me something. I did it. No, please try to learn. This homework is supposed to teach you how to look for good sites, good scientific sites on the internet, not just anything you see, that's it. It came from the internet. The internet is full of information. Some of it very poor. Some of it, it has nothing to do with science. So you have to have the ability to differentiate between what's good and what's bad. That's, and also learn about this subject. So let's take the first one, the blue baby syndrome or methemoglobinemia. Okay. You remember this is due to the high nitrate in the drinking water. So you take this particular first one and you do searches on the internet. You will have hundreds and thousands maybe of sites that will talk about it. Some of them very shallow. They are meant for regular people just to know something. You need scientific good side, so you learn about it, why the nitrate in the water is bad. So you did searches, okay, and you find, you keep looking, not for the first one or two things you see, okay, I found sites. No, you need good scientific sites that talk about this particular thing. So suppose you find the first site, okay, you would have a Word page ready. Copy that link of that page. Copy the link, which will be on top here, the address of that link. Copy the link and you paste it on that page. So that's one link, because it says submit links. Okay, let's keep on before I continue that. The links submitted should be from recognized scientific sites. So they have to be good science and of scientific nature, not somebody that tells, say, the lady how to use water which is low of nitrate when she makes the milk for her baby or something like that stupid. No, you need to learn about it. Why is it bad? Why? What's behind it? Learn from these sites that you look for and of scientific nature. Submit at least three links for every subject. So now we have this subject. You need at least three links for that one. So like I just said, you open, say, a Word page, and you found the first site, a page, and also take the link of that page, not of those. Suppose you go to EPA. You don't send the site of EPA. You send the link of that page that you liked, that you saw that it's scientific. So when the graduate student who's going to look at it presses on that link, it takes him to that page or her. Okay, so we did the first one. You keep searching, then you find another link. You save that link again on that Word page that you opened on your computer. Try to work on computers, not on your telephones. Okay, and then you keep searching again and again and again until you find, okay, say, now I found another nice site. You save it. So you need three sites for the blue baby syndrome, you save only the links. Okay, so when the graduate students presses on that link, it takes them to that page. Okay, so you have now three links for the blue baby syndrome. You send that an email. Okay, we continue here. Your grade will depend on the scientific quality of the material you submit and not on quantity alone. So if you keep saying, oh, I sent 3, 4, 5, no. What type of sites you look? So it takes time. Look at them, read, learn from them. Submit your links by email, one email for each subject. So you finish the blue baby syndrome. You have three links. Copy those links from your Word page that you saved them on. Copy paste in your email. Tell them, I am so and so and so, your name in Arabic as it is in the registration, your number. And you say, this homework is for the blue baby syndrome. Okay, so that's three links. You send that email. Where do you send it? To this email, shifagharib@gmail.com, not to me. If you send it to me, I will delete it immediately. If you send a Word file, it will be deleted immediately. If you send a PDF file, it will be deleted immediately. You did nothing. So please do not waste our time and your time. Listen carefully. Send only the links of the pages that you found and look good. Okay? So we send the first email about the blue baby syndrome. Now you go to this next, eutrophication of water bodies. You do searches on this. Again, you have a page, open a Word page. You found the first good site. Copy the link of that site and save it on that Word page. Keep looking until you find another very nice scientific site that talks about eutrophication. Copy the link, put it on that page until you have three. If you want to do more good ones, fine, but at least three good ones. If you send bad links, you take zero. It doesn't matter, even just because you say, well, I already sent the email. I want you to learn how to judge good scientific sites and to learn from them. Read the material, see that, oh, this is very good. Now I understand what does that mean. Now I really understand what's the blue baby syndrome or eutrophication and so on. So you save three links of sites for this. So again, you copy those, you send another email to the same graduate student. You send another email, inside the email, copy the links that you found on eutrophication, only the links, okay? So that when she presses on that link, she goes to the page you saw. So we judge your homework from the quality of the sites you submitted. And again, in the second homework, you do the same. You say, my name is so-and-so in Arabic, your name as it is in the registration, your ID number, and then you send it and you say, this is for eutrophication. Okay, another email. So that makes it easier for the graduate students to separate them. But if you send them all in one email, it's gonna be tough and hard. Make it easier on the graduate student who's gonna look at them. Of course, I am in contact with the graduate students, how to correct and how to that. Don't worry about that. I am aware of everything that goes on. Then you come to the third topic, acid rain. You do your searches. You do and find, okay, you open another page. You can do this. You don't have to do it at the same time. You do this, say you found one good site for this. Maybe you're tired or your internet is not doing well. Save that page on a Word page and come back again and continue your search and save until you find three good sites for each of those. So you do the same thing for acid rain. Save three sites as links again and again and again. Do not send. Already some of you started sending PDF files to the girl and this and that. That will be not acceptable. We will not correct anything, only if it is a link for a page. And we have to see that page from that link and see, judge the page from its link. Okay, so you collect three sites, so you get their links, copy paste those links one word, and then you send another, third email, say, my name is so-and-so, my number is so-and-so, your name in Arabic, your number, and you say, this is the acid rain links. Okay, and here there is a note. Wikipedia will not be accepted as a source. Do not send Wikipedia, because Wikipedia is available to everybody. I want you to look for different, more scientific. Wikipedia, some of it is excellent, some of it is not very good, because these are not dependable. They are written by people. Some of the people who write are very good, some of them are not. So it's not really that great. It's a very good source of information sometime, but do not send Wikipedia. If you send Wikipedia, it will be deleted, like you did not send. So I hope you now understand exactly what you need to do. So for each one of those three good pages, you save the links for those pages, send them in one email, you go to the next. It doesn't matter, you can do, you have until April 19th to submit the homework. So you can do every day, every other day, one of them, and send it, it's fine. You don't have to send these emails at one time. You do not have to send them the same day. Do them all as long as they arrive no later than April 19th, you will be fine. And she will record every one of you that sends. She will have a list of names, and she will say, this student submitted for the blue baby syndrome, and you know, I'll tell her how to correct them and how to grade them, okay? I hope you have understood exactly what's meant by this. If you have some other problem, you can ask me, but I think I explained it as good as can be explained. So please listen carefully to what I've told you. If you do anything else, if somebody, my friend told me so-and-so, on Facebook was so, they told us so-and-so, depend only on what I tell you. That's your responsibility. Do not get information from others. Do not get it from any other students. They'll tell you the wrong thing. They will tell you things that you should not do. If you do, you lose it. Okay? That should hopefully end it up.